From Upper Michigan Source, this is your Sports On Demand for Tuesday, December 12th. I'm Mike Ludlum. Last year, this game was a Great Northern Conference game. Next year, this will be a Great Northern Conference game. But right now, Gladstone's in the Mid-Peninsula Conference, so it's a non-conference game in girls basketball between Kingsford and Gladstone. We'll pick this up in quarter number one for the Braves. Caitlin Hardwick with the steal. She goes the other way for the layup, and the Braves have a 9-4 advantage. For the Maize and Blue, Brooke Kriegel to Renee Roberts. She floats down the lane, puts that one in. Kingsford's within three. Back the other way for Gladstone, Maddie Algren drives, dishes to Hunter Taylor, and she puts that one in. Braves back up by five. Kingsford answers again in the first quarter. Brooke Kriegel will hit that shot. Kingsford trailed by three after one, but Gladstone is your winner by the count of 52-43. On the girls' scoreboard, a couple of close games last night. Menominee defeated Iron Mountain 45-43. Calumet tiptoes past Hancock 46-43. It was Jeffers 11 better than Dollar Bay 46-35 and Chassel 40, Berrega 33. And Lons had little trouble with Wakefield Marinisco 74-32. Back to the video, how about the land of Republic Michigami, the Hawks entertaining you in Trout Creek. Second quarter, Taylan Raisinen from Allie Radcliffe for three. And on the next Hawks possession, it's Caitlin Ambuel, Taylan Raisinen to Alicia Ball on the baseline for two. And the Hawks close within 21-11. Then the Panthers go back to work. Paige Englund, Madeline Cronkwright will get the putback right there. And the Panthers are in business and they keep going that way. Berglund to Elise Bessonen in the corner. She lines up the triple, three of her 17. Of course, mom and dad are both on the bench. Brad, the JV coach, and Jackie, the varsity coach. For the Panthers, Ewan Trout Creek's Berglund to Abby LeGault for the hoop and touch foul. And ETC pulled away to take this one 72-30. On the numbers once again, Ontonagon, the 7-point winner at home over Lakeland and Humble, 48-41. Taylor Manchester at 14 points and 16 rebounds as Bessemer Turnback Waters meet 61-40. Bay College recruit Julianne Wickman had 22 for North Dickinson, 59-53, downing the Knights of Norway. Stevenson 53, North Central 45. Bark River Harris, little trouble with Big Bay to knock. In the Eastern UP, it was Detour over Maplewood Baptist and Harbor Light Christian, 72, Mackinac Island, 27. On the boys' side, the Escanaba Eskimos hosting the Houghton Gremlins. Third quarter action, Elliot Malesi to Brad Serrard. That one's good and a foul. Gremlins trying to cut it to single digits. But Benjamin Willis to Jared Nash, and the Eskimos are back up by 14. Now Willis will intercept a pass, and he will get it ahead to Ryan Robinette for the layup, two of his 31. Eskimos back up by 16. George Buttvillis will knock down a triple try for the Gremlins, but Escanaba pulls away to take this one 71-45. On the scores on the boys' side, North Dickinson gets 20 from Matthew Bruett. And the Nordics defeat Big Bay to knock 72-57. Engadine 82, Rudyard 51. Brimley cruises past Newberry. We did not hear from Pickford and St. Ignace. Detour takes care of Maplewood Baptist by a dozen, 45-33. And in college basketball, victories for the University of Michigan. The women won very easily over North Florida. Caitlin Flaherty had 27 for the Wolverines. And the men, led by double digits, led by single digits, finally settled on a 59-52 win over Texas. The NMU Wildcats are showing improvement every weekend on the ice. A case in point took place Saturday at Bemidji State. NMU had a couple leads. The Beavers tied the game twice. The Wildcats didn't let down, and their resolve helped them win the game.
One of the goals, there was controversy on whether it should or shouldn't have been a goal. One of the goals, our guy breaks a stick, and they get a breakaway. One of the goals, there's a penalty call late in the game. You just hoped it wouldn't have been called at that point of the game. But we just didn't matter. We just kept coming. And we kept coming. And then they took the lead, and we just took it right back. So, you know, we've talked about that a lot as a group, maturing as a group. Really pleased with the effort.
NMU hosts Ferris State this weekend. Michigan Tech entertains Lake Superior State. A number of events have been canceled that were scheduled for tonight. Girls basketball, Marquette at Negaunee will try again December 27th. Hockey, Marquette at Calumet, they have not announced a date on that one yet. Gladstone at Marquette boys basketball, Houghton at Ishpeming swimming, and Ishpeming at Gwynn wrestling. All will try and choose different dates down the road. The Michigan High School Volleyball Coaches Association has announced its all-state teams, Upper Peninsula getting recognition in Classes C and D. Calumet's Leah Bijorn is on the Class C third team as an outside hitter. Honorable mention goes to her teammate Amber Johnson as libero. In Division I, Aubrey Simmons of Engadine, their fine middle hitter, gets first team recognition, so definitely congratulations to her. Rudyard had a number of players named to the D list. On the third team is Sydney Zerp, their middle hitter. Honorable mention went to Lane Clegg and Sierra Dugan. Munising's Darren Johnson as outside hitter. The Bulldogs' Jordan Spring as a libero. And Cayenne Wendt, Munising's fine outside hitter, also getting honorable mention.